Yeah, my tomatoes at the side of the house are a mess. We're house painting, so we had a big storm yesterday, so the ladder blew down. There's another ladder. I hope this one didn't get damaged, but again, I only have one fruit on this plant. One fruit on that plant. And then, ooh, that's a nice size one. Look at this one. Let me see if I can get a close up. Oh, yeah. This is the Amish paste. Yeah, it's nice. But one tomato per plant is not what I was counting on. So something's got to give. There's some taller plants, but nope, they're not doing very good. I'll figure that one out next year. These tomatoes really used to do really well this side of the house, but they were planted in the ground, so I'm not sure what's going on here. On to the next. Here's another sunflower. Bees like sunflowers too. So if you want bees in your garden, plant sunflowers and herbs, and you'll do pretty good. Oh. Sun shining on the screen here. I can't see what I'm filming. Let's see. Beefsteaks. Somebody asked me, made a comment on one of the videos, if we put Tums in the water, will it keep the tomatoes, the new tomatoes coming out, will it keep them from getting blossom end rot, even if other fruit have had it? Yes, it will, because blossom end rot is not contagious. It has to do with the amount of calcium in the fruit and the ability for the tomatoes to grow, have fast growth spurts. So for instance, if you're watering a couple times a week and then it gets really dry, and then you go and water again, all of a sudden there's a big growth spurt because, oh, they've gotten water. That will cause blossom end rot if the tomato doesn't have enough calcium in it to, deal with that growth spurt. So I try to keep mine watered on a regular basis, and of course in these containers that have the water reservoir in the bottom with a wicking system so that they're always watered from the roots. And there are a couple of tomatoes on here that have blossom end rot, but not all of them do. So tomatoes at the side of the shed, afternoon sun tomatoes. The Amish paste again. I don't know. I called the lady at Terra Edibles, and that's where I got my seeds from, and she said to flick the flowers when they're flowering because they self-pollinate. So I'm doing that, but still, you know, one tomato per plant is just not acceptable. Now these ones were damaged when the branch of the tree fell in a storm. It fell on top of those plants, so I'm just glad they survived. I got some tomatoes in there. But it's not yielding, you know, enough to make sauce. Those are the Romas. They're still pretty small. You know, they're ripening. They're turning orange, but they're tiny. So, grape and cherry. I think these are, I'm not sure which is which. There's grape tomatoes and there's cherry tomatoes in these bags. I'm not sure. I didn't mark them, so. Okay. Okay, the garden in the compost. Last year's tomatoes, look, I still got flowers on there, that we threw out are giving us a harvest this year, and they're starting to ripen, so I'm going to, that one's kind of cracked, but I'm going to pick those. There's a few more in here. And on to the garden in the shade. Considering this is shady, beefsteak tomatoes are doing well. They don't have the yield that I would like to see on them, like the other plants in the containers. However, the rabbits did eat the tops off of these when they were starting to grow out here, so it took them longer to grow. But this particular plant has some pretty good fruit on it. Nice cluster there. And tiny little tomatoes. This one's a little bigger. And then the green peppers. Hopefully I'll get something bigger than a nickel off of these. They're flowering. And then the little tiny aroma tomatoes over here, the ripening. Look at these. Let me see if I can get a close up better. Look how little they are. They're so tiny. They look like cherry tomatoes. But they're Roma. They look like little grape tomatoes. Huh. They're still flowering. Those look like little grape tomatoes too. And then I have the butternut squash, which is growing all over the garden, which is fine. Except they're all male flowers coming out. They've got the pollen. See? They're the stems with the pollen, but I don't have any female flowers yet. So I'm not counting really on any butternut squash this year, but we'll see. And the zucchini, that one's getting pretty big. And another one in here. Tiny sunflower. It's only tiny because it was planted in the shade. And no, I did not plant it in the shade. Oh, looks like there's some sweet pea flowers roaming through the garden here. These were the bush beans. They didn't come up too well this year. I had a hard time with them. We're just letting them go to seed. We could use our seeds. Okay, so I guess that's it for now. We'll see what happens with the change of the weather.